My name is Vjekoslav Nemec, and welcome to 26th Bošnjaci Open Chess Tournament vlog. Let's go! So this is our accommodation, apartments Baltic. We have a nice breakfast and shirt and it looks really nice and people seem nice, so yeah. Two guys, three bets, all good. So we are here inside the playing hall, so let's see how it looks. Of course the situation is before the tournament, but some people are still already at it. Strongest chess player in Nova Gradiška, Sten Boban. Sten, what are your expectations for this tournament?
I'm going to win it easily. No, my only expectation for this tournament is to be in front of Vjekoslav Nemec.
And to beat him in the mutual game, yeah?
Yeah, and if I somehow lose, if miracle happens, then I'll make sure that I should
get some English lessons, maybe.
Yeah, maybe that first, but after that I should lose every single game because I don't want him to gain like
too many buchos.
Yeah, too many buchos.
Okay, so I just won my first round encounter. It was a youngster. Thinking it was a really decent game, relatively good game, but you know, first open after 4 years, man, the nerves are real. Gonna go back to the hall to see what's happening. Okay, and there are people watching me from the car, looking what am I doing. It is now 10:43 and the preparation for the next round are in full swing. So my opponent plays the hedgehog, so let me check a little bit if I can access it. Okay. Perks of being the admin. So we'll most likely play the hedgehog, so I'll now check some games, and I have also checked some games on the in the database and did some analysis of my own. So that's basically how preparation looks. Gurga, what are the impressions of day one?
Day one was excellent. I had an excellent game, and now currently I am relaxing.
No, I mean we are still preparation for the game. You can see the deal. Yeah, this is the best part of every chess tournament, I would say.
Yes.
Okay, who this? Mortal Kombat downloads? Not yet.
Soon.
Soon.
Day two has become. Sun has risen. Double round. Let's go.
changes.
Okay, so here we are in the analysis room after the second round, and my opponent and I will do a small post-mortem. So, yeah, here is the... You can watch the game live, and my opponent brushes in defeat. Okay. Round 3 starts in 25 minutes. Both Grga and I are heavy underdogs, but I'm playing against GM on board 1, Grga against FM.
On board 7.
On board 7. Plans to offer a draw.
Right at the beginning. To unbalance the opponent. He will think I'm bad and he will underestimate me.
Yeah. It will be tough, but he who survives, there is wins, or however they say, in Wagner Fools and Horses. Let's go, let's see. Okay, so I was in very bad manner, very embarrassing fashion, but okay. Tough to play against GMs. The life goes on, the tournament goes on. Now let's take a look what's happening in the hall and pay attention to one 13 rated 100 guy who's just casually beating FM. Totally not underrated. Okay, he's a piece down, I didn't see that, but you know, definitely still underrated. Anyway, this was a tough day. Two rounds is tough, man. Don't understand how people play three in America. But time to for some fun now. So it is day 4 of the tournament. Yeah, yesterday was unnecessary and shameful, but the life goes on, and now it's time to do the most important thing, refresh and get some groceries for the game. So yeah, it is always a bit question like what to eat during a tournament, what to eat during a game, and yeah, I'm not a nutrition expert, of course, obviously, but I recently read a very good article by Noel Studer on his next level chess blog, where he recommended some, basically his main recommendation was to keep the glucose level as stable as possible throughout the game, so no extensive sweets, no Coca-Cola, even no energy drinks, even though, for example, my coach told me that it is good to take coffee somewhere in the middle of the game if you feel your energy is lacking, but then again, it's a big high and then even bigger low. So far it's hard to tell. I've been being on bananas and water throughout the games. It has been working okay, although yesterday in the afternoon I completely lost concentration. It's hard to tell whether it was how much the nutrition affected it. I think it might be also for the majority of mortals and non-professional players, like, yeah, super fools, right? Because it may make a difference at like 2, 3, 4%. But we have much bigger problems and holes in our knowledge to be concerned about health, so about healthy eating. But okay, I might be, once again, that's just my personal opinion, that, you know, you start fixating over food and stuff, you eat too much, and instead of, you know, thinking about chess. So yeah, today I'm playing a youngster. Not too happy with my pairings again. He has 2.5 out of 3, and he beat... He drew against a 2200 rated player and beat a 2150 rated player. So and his rating is 1960, so he should be underrated. But let's see, I have prepared some line in the accelerated dragon, which I saw his play, so hope it will go well. I am really nervous about the game and I really don't feel well physically, but yeah, it is what it is. Ups and downs are parts of a tournament life, so let's go.
We are here, we have just eaten in front of Konama Bertic, so this is the playing hall and we are very, very near. It's 20 minutes before the round. How are you feeling, Crash? What prognosis for the game?
Well, after the devastating losses in the last round, today we have to rebound and destroy our opponents. So I'm very confident that we will succeed in this.
I am not so confident. I'm playing a youngster, as I said, and I'm fucking nervous as fuck. But that's the reality of chess tournament life, I guess. Or if you pretend you care about it. So yeah. I'm literally in my car after my fourth round game. I won, but I mean, and it was actually, I think it was relatively convincing, but man, this took 10 lives out of me.
Another double round today will be tough. Krga, ready to get back to 7 out of 9?
Yeah. 7 out of 9 with the worst Buchholz is my goal. So.
Yeah, unfortunately he lost yesterday, but I'm sure he'll bounce back today.
Yeah, wait.
Yeah.
I'm playing white.
Yeah.
Not what white power.
At least you won FIFA yesterday.
Yes. Yeah. And Zuger.
And Blitz, yeah.
Blitz, yeah.
Here with International Master Sven Tica, currently co-leading the tournament with 100% 4 out of 4. How are you confident so far, and what do you expect from today's game against Shari Chante, the number one seed?
Well, so far the game, I played them very well, but today is going to be the toughest challenge of them all because of K's Grandmaster first seed with black, so not ideal pairing, but hey, we got to play, so...
We will play for a draw for a win.
I'll just play.
Okay.
If a winning chance occurs, of course, I'll try to take it. If not, yeah.
Very diplomatic. Thank you.
Yeah,
and
trying my best.
Good luck.
Thank you.
So I just won round 5. I'm at 4 out of 5. I finally managed to win a boy Grunfeld successfully after that buckle in round 3. And yeah, I'm expecting somebody strong again in the afternoon round. And we'll see how it goes. I'm super happy. I'm... If the tournament were now to end, I would have like peak elo ever. So yeah, I'm super happy. On the other hand, I also am not happy because I might have the ugliest handwriting of all time. I mean, look at this shit.
So lunchtime at a local, last time I asked for half of pizza, they didn't have it, and now I'm famous as a guy who asked for half a pizza. Let's see if what has changed today.
No, I think they'll throw you off.
Half pizza, Nemec. Strikes again.
Yeah.
Hardest task, deciding what to wear for the next round.
Yeah, we'll go with that one. Also, I don't think we'll wear these jeans anymore.
I wore them for 2 rounds.
So round 6 is on cards. Here is some effects of the prep. I'm expecting a dangerous dragon, and I'm hoping for this queen sacrifice that goes after e5, b4, ef, queen. Queen takes f6 to happen. Just so you know that if anybody sees this after the game, I had this in prep. I'm not cheating on the board. Grga, how is the situation? You won?
Yeah, I won today, but in the afternoon I'm playing with a club.
Teammate, yeah.
So it will be
tough. Always
tough. Yeah,
psychology. Tough. Okay, let's go.
I played 5 hours, I ended last, but I won winning the tournament for now. It's day 5 of the tournament. We visited Grga's parents today, but I didn't film because I was not allowed to film. In the end, I could have filmed, but I didn't, but it was nice, we made a day trip to Osijek. Grga is now chilling before the game, and
yeah, you can show the game. I don't know if you can show it because of the copyright. Maybe you can.
Nah.
But this is my preparation for
the beacher.
Like swimming and stuff like that.
Yeah, physical fitness and stuff.
Business.
Yeah, and of course I'm nerding away. expecting some London system today potentially, so here we are, some peek inside into some Swedware files. Oops, leaked. Don't fire me, Chessable. So we'll see what happens. Crasher is in live, I'm playing my second GM, so let's hope for the best. See ya after the round. We are back in the apartment the day after day six, which the day six, yes, yesterday after the game I was banned from filming because Gruga was already in his pajama and but yeah, I lost a very tough, very long and a very instructive game, but Gruga Gerga there, he won in a very nice fashion. So what happened in your game yesterday? It was a spectacle.
It was spectacular. My opponent was deep in thought and he lost sense of time and his flag. He was flagged, so he was very surprised. He was expecting another half hour to be added to his clock even without moving or pressing the clock, so I don't know what happened. He was very, very disappointed with his appearance, with his...
To clarify, like there is, in some tournaments you have, so depending on the tempo, you do indeed get 30 minutes extra after 40 moves, and the procedure is to let your time run out and then you get it. It actually happened to Maike when she was playing in Croatian League, because she didn't know the time control, but it is a little bit weird for it to expect to happen in round 7, and also in Croatia almost all tournaments are played without that additional time, so it was kind of surprising. But yeah, this means that Gerga is now taking the tournament very seriously, so he was prepared today for a good 10 minutes, so he knows his opponent and what he will play.
Definitely, so we will see. I have 4.5 points, I'm hoping to end with 6.5, so today I'm playing with black and we will surprise my opponent with my special preparation, 10 minute preparation, and as you can see we are
about to start the best preparation. This is FIFA 2020, so yeah, this so far the score is approximately 15-4 for Gerga, but I'm fighting on. Guess who was Inter? Guess what, it wasn't Gerga. So it's final day, we are taking round is early in the morning, 9:30, and we are driving back from Zagreb. Make it or break it in the tournament. Oh, and yes, Gerga here, he's the champion of FIFA for Bošnjaci. He beat me 5-0 yesterday with Juventus against Barcelona, but Ronaldo scored only one or two goals.
Hat-trick.
Ah, okay, yes. Yesterday, two were by Khedira or somebody. Yeah, so we are currently finishing, wrapping things up, preparing to say goodbye. And then to play one final game, so we'll see what happens.
Maybe the last round begins early, but at least it's the coldest day of the year and I have to clean my car.
For one last time. Okay, so I managed to draw my final game, very, very luckily actually. I was quite lost and very, very much worse during the entire game. My opponent played some weird, you know, tactical chess, but overall I'm happy with the result. 6.5 out of 9, almost 30 rating points plus, and yeah, I will take a prize, one of the prizes, so super happy. Gerga is still playing, I will try to film a little bit, unfortunately he is lost. And yeah, overall it was a really, really nice tournament. It was great to be back in the arena after 3 years since my last Open, and happy that all the hard work does pay off in the end. So yeah, looking forward to the next one. We'll be right back.
We are here with International Master Sven Tica, the winner of the second place. Congratulations, Sven. How was the tournament? Tell us.
Well, the tournament was tough, obviously. Ante Šarić was the first seed, by far the best player in the field.
I mean, Grandmaster Ante Šarić for our international audience, thank you.
Yes, he had 100 rating points ahead of everyone, so it was expected that he would win. I had my chances, maybe I could have played better the last two rounds, missing some winning chances, but all in all, I mean, second place, I cannot really complain.
Yeah, okay. So, a nice pocket change, some rating points. What's next? What's your next tournament? What's your next goal? When is the chase for the GM title begin? Or has it already begun?
It's kind of begun with the Austrian League, with the already first four rounds being played. So, the next stop is 24th of March. So, hopefully I can continue the good form there.
Okay, awesome. That's all. I know that you won't be as talkative. We'll get to Sten next. But thank you, congratulations, and good luck returning home.
Thank you very much. I will need it.
Okay, we are here with Sten Boban after that professional interview. But with International Master, it's time for some entertainment. Sten, 5 out of 9. A lot of points for a player of your caliber. How are you satisfied with the tournament and overall can performance? Because of the mic.
I'm not very satisfied, but I came here to be with people and to enjoy entertainment and to have fun, not to play chess. And also, I wanted to ruin Nemeth's tournament, but it didn't go as planned. So maybe some next time I'll have an opportunity for something like that.
At least you won some blitz games and showed a couple of tricks.
Some blitz games. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
So I am back home after a fight. This will be the final piece of the first ever vlog. It's currently around 11 p.m. because I had to charge my camera's battery because it kept dying during the tournament. I obviously shaved for this final piece of the video. So yeah, what to say about the tournament? I'm extremely happy, of course. I really played well and you know, I've been working on my chess very seriously, you know, basically since for at least a year, but even more seriously since August when I got my coach. And there were a couple of moments where I lost some games in the league where I felt immediate frustration, but it's kind of nice to see all this pay off. But even though I'm obviously, when I'm in a tournament, I want to be focused on the tournament and I'm like being hardcore into chess, especially today, you know, when it's more about when you are talking to people and hanging out, I kind of realized fully that, you know, even though chess is important, the relationships and friendships and community and friends you meet through chess and are actually something even more important. And connecting with people and talking to people about chess and you know, driving home with full car of people and sharing our passion, it was really, really nice. I also met up with two friends of mine here in Zagreb. After that, both chess players as well. Obviously, you know, when I was back, this was my first Open in 3 years, and last time I played was in Pavel Hora Open 2018, and I lost 30 rating points. And you know, it was a strange feeling because I was there only with Leon, with Ivich, but there wasn't this feeling of broader community. And also I did poorly. So yeah, I kind of told myself that I will not play another Open unless I'm fully prepared and I'm working at chess. But I'm also kind of happy that was fulfilled, but that I also played in Croatia in a very nice Open with a very friendly atmosphere with many great people. And it was also great to reconnect with some older old friends or old people I knew who I wouldn't necessarily call friends, but also to meet some new ones. And I think, yeah, in the end, friendships and relationships are all what it should all be about. And yeah, which is kind of my excuse for attempting to vlog it and document it in a way. So yeah, we'll see what the future brings. The grind must continue. And I'm looking forward to the next tournament. And here, Marozzi brought me many points, so I'll just continue studying it, of course. See, until next time.